Yo.
Yo, 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 yo.
Triple yo.
Super mange gange velkommen til The WaxWarrior Show her på Vibe 5.
Tak.
Som så vanlig, også til dig, Benjamin.
Ja, tak.
Som så vanlig er vi mig, Ian, og dig.
Benjamin Madsen.
Ja, tak. A.k.a. Benster.
A.k.a. Ham, der får damerne til at smide trusserne.
Åh, sygt nok der. Nå, okay.
Ja, ja.
Jamen, vi har nogle gæster i studiet. Vi har Ken Kuusk.
En gammel kending. Ja. Ikke kælling, en gammel kending.
Som var inde og gæste os inde på Søhesten. Det var dejligt.
Ja, da vi havde vores gyldne tider derinde.
Ja.
Det var og gode 3 måneder, mand.
Han er tilbage, og han har taget en ven med. The Librarian, men han har så ikke lige fået taget noget musik med, for det var en lille misforståelse. Men vi snakker nok lidt med ham om hans label og hans releases og sådan lidt forskelligt.
Ja, og hvad der sker, og hvad der ligesom rører på sig i Librarians liv.
Yes. Og så spiller Ken nogle plader. Han siger ikke så meget. Han er ikke sådan en big word guy, som han selv siger. Så han spiller nogle plader, og det kan I se, hvis I går ind på vores Facebook-side.
Det kan jeg.
WaxWarriors på Facebook. Der kører en video stream lige nu.
Video stream.
Og det er
han
helt
og jeg kan sige så meget, at han har taget hans pragtfulde løvemanke med. Han ser pis godt ud.
Hvem?
Ken Kuusk, man.
Nå, hans løvemanke. Ja, okay. Godt. Vi skal også høre noget musik.
Det skal vi da. Hvad hører vi derovre?
Som vi spiller, der hører vi Cozy Bear. Med Nudie Rhythm. Ja, det er dejligt. Det er på Samit's label, ELE Records. Jeg tror, den er kommet ud nu. Yep. Faktisk, men jeg har haft den i promo i gennem sit tid, hvor vi har spillet diverse ting og sager. Men altså, Cozy Bear med Nudie Rhythm. Lad os høre den, og så... ja.
Velkommen til.
Velkommen til. We'll be right back. Ja tak. Nudie Rhythm. Cozy Bear. Her får vi en plade med Muffin Tarkin. Tracket hedder, det hedder I Got This. We'll be right back. Ja tak. Muffin Tarkin, I got this.
Do you got this?
Yeah, I do. Her får vi Johnny Conga. Edit 002. Ja tak.
Right. Det var ret lækkert, det der. Edit 002 med Johnny Conga. Lige her en relativt ny skive med Tillman. Den hedder Time to Reflect EP. Det er nogle sjove navne, de har, de EP'er. Tracket, der hedder Every Damn Day. Og det er ude på det sublime pladeselskab, som hedder Quality Vibe Records. Hvis ikke jeg tager helt fejl, så har jeg spillet et eller to tracks fra den her EP allerede i radioshowet. Men nu får I lige også den her i Turk Turk. Superswaggeren. Her er noget super motherfucking hemmeligt. Det er så hemmeligt, at jeg ikke engang ved, hvad det er. Jeg ved bare, at jeg købte den for et stykke tid siden på dj.de. To tracks på den her EP. En på hver side af pladen. De kører begge to i 45 rounds per minute. Og sådan er det bare bonusinfo, lige gyldig viden.
nemlig spillet en ret så sej plade, som hverken han eller jeg ved hvad er. Skide godt. Men det var fedt. Der er noget, der ligner fraktaler på på centerlabelen. Anyways, her der får vi Move D på hans seneste udgivelse på Compost Black Label. Og her det er tracket, der hedder Horsin' Around. Nej, undskyld. Housin' Around. Tager en lille track med Marquise Hawks. Ja, det er en track, der hedder Tower Block Boogie. Og med et lille øjeblik tager vi lige en lille snak med Librarian om hans label og nogle af hans nye releases og omkring genudgivelser og Vinyl Only og jeg ved ikke hvad. Og efter det, så skal vi have Ken, der allerede står og er ved at gøre klar med hans digitale tracks. Ham skal vi have på The Decks og spille lidt musik. Det bliver helt lækkert. Stay tuned. Now, actually, we've had him here for all the show, but now we're going to have a little talk with the librarian, Dragos.
What's up, guys?
Dragos, right?
What's yeah, we're supposed to play today, but we kind of like... Are you allowed to say bad words here? Or
yeah, of course.
I kind of fucked it up. I didn't really brought my records. It was like kind of a misunderstanding, so... Yeah. But we can just talk, so...
Yeah, we'll just talk to you a little bit. So, Dragos, you are also... except for being the librarian, you're also the label runner of Waxed Effects, right?
Yeah, sure.
And what was your mission in running that label?
We didn't really have a mission. We're just like a bunch of friends, and we decided to press some records, and that was about it, you know.
That's about it. No real mission.
Nah, no real mission. We're okay. Just having fun. So.
No plan for the. What about like genres for the releases? Any specific style or just like anything you like?
Anything.
Anything
like,
you
now
like.
We're working on a jungle release, so I don't know if people are gonna like that, but whatever, you know.
Okay, jungle release. Nice. Cool. Is it gonna be like hard or a little bit more like fluid or?
Well, you know, like it started to be hard, but like it's becoming a bit more fluid now because I'm pretty much the only guy that started with a drum and bass background, you know, and the other guys are a bit more softish, so they're kind of like pushing me back a bit, and I was like, yeah, okay.
Yeah, yeah, okay.
Let's not make it hard then.
No. And how many copies did you start by making of the first ones that you pressed?
Well, actually, we started with 300 because nobody wanted to, like, you know, press more. Oh. Because everyone was like, yeah, guys, we don't really know who you are, and let's just start with 300. And we were like, yeah, okay. Let's do it.
and they sold out pretty fast, right?
Yeah, like 2 weeks, I think, actually.
For the first release,
yeah, for all of them,
all of
much.
Them, yeah,
like
yeah,
2 weeks, one
yeah.
week, stuff like that.
So you started upping the numbers on the later ones.
Yeah,
right?
we did.
Yeah, and but now actually, your all the releases are being re-released, repressed.
Actually, if you just check our Facebook, we have the dates announced, and it's from the first one until the fifth one. We didn't really manage to repress the sixth one because we decided to repress before the sixth one was already out. You know. So
yeah. Okay. But
just made the order before.
Yeah?
But now it's kind of easy to grab them, you know, and you don't have to pay like much money for the Discogs guys.
Yeah, that's the whole thing because most of these are vinyl only labels that are like very limited pressings. When people sell them on Discogs, it's like
it's kind of like a
very fast. It's like 200 euros. That's
people
insane.
Are just
I hate
hustling
that.
And stuff.
Yeah, exactly. So rather the money goes into your pockets by repressing than.
We don't really, of course, like, you know, I'm probably not the first guy that's going to say that we don't make a lot of money from record sales
or
something like that.
But it's nice to, when you do the repressings, of course, you make more.
Yeah, we just want our record out, you know, so that people can have it and they don't have to pay a lot of ridiculous money to, like, random people. So it's kind of like a very simple concept that we're running, you know.
Yeah,
we just want to give people music.
That's good. What about you haven't considered Bandcamp at all? No digital whatsoever?
We did at some point, but not yet. Not yet.
Not yet. Okay. Yeah. But you had it in the works, but
yeah, we kind of had it in the pipeline at some point. It's gonna happen, maybe, but not so sure about it.
Well, the whole thing with digital, if you keep it on places like Bandcamp, then you will make more money for you and for the artist than on Beatport or TrackSource or whatever.
Yeah, exactly. But
and the people who buy stuff at Bandcamp, they're not as they're not as piratey as a lot of other people are, so you won't risk as much getting it pirated.
But like, you know, if we're just like gonna be real, then it's just gonna get pirated anyway.
Yeah,
so.
of course. But yeah, anyways, at one point when you've sold enough digital vinyl copies, then of course it would be nice for the people who really don't buy vinyl to be able to get them at some point.
At the end of the day, like, what's important is that like everyone that wants our music has it. So we're gonna kind of try and help the digital guys out somehow. I don't know how, but.
Yeah. What about your own productions? You were with one track on the first release, and then
actually two of them.
Two of them.
Yeah. And then yeah. I made an EP, and then I decided that I should probably make an album.
So yeah. I'm just so there's an album in the works now.
Yeah, kind of like 30% done, probably, or something like that.
Okay.
But I'm pretty happy about it, so it's gonna be really dope.
Okay. Cool. But then, of course, you'd have to come back at one point and bring music.
Yeah, for sure. Like whenever you guys want. I mean.
Yeah.
You know, I just moved to Copenhagen. So.
Oh, you did. Fuck. That's good. Yeah. That's nice. Then it's no problem. Then.
Yeah.
We'll just figure out a date with you and then
every
we'll do
Thursday.
It. Yeah. Every Thursday is Librarian Day. No. well, that's cool. That's cool. I'm really looking forward because I just pre-ordered the first four ones.
I shouldn't have.
Today.
I could just like give them to you
oh,
next
yeah,
time when I visit you. So
oh,
it's
nice,
really nice place.
But
I like supporting like local stuff.
Oh, that's cool. But now I already put them in the basket.
That's cool.
It puts the records in the basket, or else it gets the hose.
All right, I'm gonna give you the next ones. Then.
Oh, that's nice. Cool, man. Thanks. Well, it's been nice having you here, and now we want to hear some tunes from Ken, I think.
Yeah, let's do it.
Ken has brought some really cool shit, and for sure, we dug his last set, and I'm sure we're going to dig this one as well. So, whenever you're ready, Ken, we're ready for you. Ken Kuusk in the mix. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. மைனா பாட பாட கூட கூட
ராகத்தோடு பாட பாட தாளத்தோடு கூட கூட ஆடி பாடி கூட கூட
பாடி கூட கூடாதோ மைனா கொஞ்சம் வா
super nice set fra Ken Kuusk. Det var også helt dope sidst, der var inde og spille hos os på Søhesten. Og han gjorde det sgu igen i dag. Dope selection. Tak, Ken. Tak. Den her, vi får her, det er den gule plade, som Benjamin ville have kaldt den. Her er det Shining Bright med Vinyl Addicted.
Oh yeah. Og vi går direkte fra den gule plade over til den sorte plade. Ja, det er Glenn Underground. En plade, jeg fik i fødselsdagsgave af Ian. Hvad sker der? Tak endnu en gang, Ian. Et nummer, der hedder Do You Like It? Den her, den går ud til alle dem, der har ondt i ryggen. Det er Mr. G. Med nummeret, som hedder Back Pain. Lige om lidt, så siger vi tak for i aften. Men indtil da, så lad os lige bange derudad med vores dårlige rygge.
Yes. God aften, god nat, god velkommen og farvel.
Farvel.
vi har en gæst næste uge.
Det har vi da i hvert fald som så vanligt.
Jamen, kan du huske hvem egentlig? Det er du også.
Ja tak, sådan der. Nu er lidt højere. Yes. Ja tak, så kører det.
Næste uges gæst er faktisk en, vi har snakket om her i studiet. Det er den alle tiders kanadier, Chris Percy.
Oh, snappity snap.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Det bliver rigtig fedt.
Det bliver så
fedt. Og det glæder vi os meget til.
Fuck yeah.
Så tune ind næste uge. Tak til vores gæster i dag. Ken.
Thank you guys.
Ken Kuusk. And thank you so much for...
Librarian.
Librarian Dragos for being here. And we will have him back in the studio playing some actual tunes at one point.
Yeah. Yes. So, check this out.
Yeah. So, stay tuned for the podcast coming up soon.
Very soon. Godnat og tak for, at I har lyttet med og sov helt fantastisk. Eller fest derudad, det er jo torsdag.
Yes. Hej.
Hej.